captain has turned on the seatbelt light. Please take your seat and fasten your seatbelts. Thank you.
Here's what's new in Lingo 10. First, there have been some huge enhancements that give you more flexibility when creating a new Lingo project. Dynamic filtering. You can now filter a source flare project by target or conditions. Filtering by target allows you to create a Lingo project that includes only files from a specific flare target. Filtering by condition excludes files and content marked with specific condition tags. This lets you break down large flare projects into smaller chunks. Snippet and variable flattening. This replaces the snippet or variable content with text in the translation editor. Translating a snippet or variable as part of a segment allows translators to account for context in the segment. This also ensures that you have the most accurate translations in your translation memory. DITA enhancements. DITA support has been significantly enhanced in Lingo 10. First, several new element types are now supported for translation, including glossary terms, index terms, and cross-references. Even more importantly, Lingo now supports content references, or conrefs, for translation. This is beneficial because it allows authors of DITA projects to translate reusable content elements in their project. In addition to supporting conrefs for translation, Lingo 10 allows you to flatten conrefs and replace them with text in the translation editor. Additionally, you can now filter your DITA projects to include one or more conditional attributes. The resulting Lingo project will include all of the content that's marked with the selected attribute, while excluding content that's not selected. Also in Lingo 10 are all kinds of enhancements that improve Lingo's integration with Flare. Font mapping. If you're translating a Flare project into multiple languages, you may need to use different fonts for each language. This ensures that the characters display correctly when viewed in the output. You can use Lingo's font mapping feature to locate the fonts already used in the source Flare project and map them to the fonts that are supported by each target language. Index and glossary sort orders. There may be times that you want to create a custom sort order for your Flare index or glossary. You can do this by adding a sort as term to the index or glossary term. Custom sort orders are especially important when translating a Flare project because terms in each translated language may have different spellings or pronunciations that are not automatically picked up by Flare. Because of this, you may need to specify how the index or glossary should sort a term. That way, the term is identified correctly when the Lingo project is exported back to Flare. Language skins. When you create your Lingo project, you have the option to add a language skin to your project. This generates a file containing several terms used in different Flare skins, such as Table of Contents, Glossary, and Home. Translators can open the language skin file to translate these terms. This is especially useful if there are custom terms in the Flare skin and they need to be translated to match the custom interface. Later, when output is generated from Flare, the translations in the language skin replace Flare's default translations for interface elements. We've also added source control support in Lingo 10. This includes integrated support for Subversion, Git, Team Foundation Server, and Perforce. Additionally, because Lingo uses a wide-open architecture and stores files as independent XML files, such as XLF, you can manually manage your files in an external source control system. What else is new in Lingo, you say? How about these great features? Command line. Lingo now supports the command line for managing your projects. You can use this utility to export, update, and compare projects. You can also create a batch file to use with a scheduling tool, so you can export or update projects automatically. File type support enhancements. Improvements have been made to Lingo's file type support. You can now translate metadata in Flare target files for PDF and EPUB targets. And FrameMaker files, previously supported only for translation, are now supported for review. Additionally, you can now import any unrecognized file type, including custom file types, by using a text file filter. Global dictionaries and spell check enhancements. You can now add global dictionaries so all of your projects are using the same spellings for terms. You can also use project-level dictionaries in case you need to use special spellings for certain projects. Additionally, the spell check window pane has been redesigned with more options, including access to your global and project dictionaries. Image replacement. You can now replace your project images using a batch image replacement process. You can also do this for multiple languages at once, which makes it quick and easy to localize images in multilingual projects. Additionally, you can use the Replace Skin Images tool to localize the images in your skin files. Plus, we've added many other new features and enhancements, such as 64-bit support. a new TOC view window pane, which is useful when translating Flare projects, a new project properties dialog, which lets you control project-wide settings in one place, a redesigned align tool, various enhancements in the translation editor, improved support for smart quotes, project export enhancements, two new QA reports, and redesigned report styling. For additional details about these changes, open the What's New topic in the online help, or you can download the What's New PDF guide. Enjoy the new Lingo 10.